Aswan. Dunne, in onmiddellijkheid met meteen zijn in one. So I use that as the topic of the poem. I just wrote the poem. So Mr. Lowe kept going to everywhere. He told me again, he came back to me after consulting a lot of people. He came back to me and said, look, you're getting your 20 over 20, 100% for the poem, even if you copied it. Just tell me where you copied it from. I repeated the same answer. And then he said, I believe you. Then he ran to the principal and showed him the poem. The principal was excited and he told his wife to come and persuade me to disclose where I copied the poem. But because the wife liked me a lot. She was a mathematics master.
Okay.
And she was a graduate of Cambridge.
Wow.
Even me, the principal was a graduate of Cambridge. Mr. Lowe was a graduate of Oxford. And the two of them were always fighting. Which university was the best. Now, Mrs. Simpson came and talked to me. I went back to the husband and I said, he wrote everything. And that was how it was. But it did not become the college anthem until I left the school.
Wow.
About 2 years after I left the school.
Who was responsible?
So that was my most memorable event. The second one was, of course, the day I won my boxing colors.
Wow.
Okay, sir. Prior to this year, when writing, was there no school anthem in existence then?
No, there was none. There was none. And by the way, I wrote the poem in class 2 or class 3.
I have one other question for you. The name Government College Umuahia is synonymous with academic excellence. Going by the antecedents of school certificate results, that is, start ranging from when it was Cambridge, WAEC, and so on and so forth. This has been very consistent. What, if I may ask, is responsible for this?
Two things, in my opinion, were responsible. One, the ratio of master to student was very low. One master to about 14, 15 students. In other words, the school was very well staffed. In my time, we had 8 white masters and 6 black masters. We refer to our tutors as masters, not tutors or teachers. Second point was that the discipline there was very, very strict. It was modeled after the public schools in England, Eton and Harrow. Therefore, the quality of teaching was very, very high.
What do you take, if it's not raised?
Okay, ask a question.
Yes, ask.
Okay. Assume, please, I remember once I was in the library and I saw on the desk where I saw the inscription, Chinua Achebe, and I was struck. I just want to know, at that time in our country, what did it feel like to be a student of Government College? I mean, there must have been excellence that brought you there. What about inside you as a student? Was there any peculiar feeling going to a school like Government College at that time, you know, 47, 48, and then about?
Well, yes, it was to go to Government College of Mary. In our time, the class was an average of 30 people in the whole class. And even then, most classes didn't have the full complement of 30. Because of one thing or the other. Somebody might be sick, I'm not sure. The class will be about 29, 28. And then some places were reserved for Cameroonians. And once or twice, they could not meet their quota. And by the time they could not meet their quota, the school had already started. So it was prestigious to go to my... Many of us took entrance to two or three secondary schools. And if you passed to my, you forgot the others. But then, when we got in, we were not proud at all. There was no showmanship. In fact, if you boasted to other schools, apart from joking with your friends, you were punished. So we were very, very modest at Umuahia. In my own case, if I can take it as an example, I passed entrance to Umuahia from standard 6. In that time, you had to take the entrance from standard 6. And I passed entrance to Okreka Grammar School, which was the best Anglican, the best secondary school at that time by the Anglican Church. I passed it too. Then I was offered a scholarship by the Anglican Church to choose between the Okreka Priscilla Grammar School and DNGS. Because the paper was the same, the exam was the same exam paper for all the grammar schools. So I was rejoiced that I won a scholarship and I wanted to go to DMGS. But when I told my father, he said, no, you'll go to mine. So his neighbors from Enugu and Agena, Ojiobu and all those people from Anambra, who were living with my father in Port Harcourt, he said, look at this foolish man. He wants to go and pay fees, but then they say he can go to DNGS without paying fees. My father insisted that I go to mine, that he will pay. Because I passed as a fee-paying student to mine. Well, my classmate and best friend, the late Michael Mwachukwu, who became a professor in Fulton, he lectured at Nsukka. He set up the electrical engineering laboratories. He was always beating me in primary school, and both of us were the only ones who passed from the whole of our bar center and went to Maya together, and we were also in the same class. And we were sitting side by side at St. Michael's School at Bar. We were sitting side by side. Government College of Maya, we were sitting by side. He won a scholarship, open scholarship, what was called exhibition scholarship. In the whole of Owerri province, he came first. So, in spite of that, my father told me to go to mine.
There is something I am wondering if you missed out. So I'd like to ask you if the spirit of competition that I met in Government College Umuahia, because our numbers were higher and our teachers were fewer. And we knew we had an obligation to still keep the flag of the school flying. So we tasked ourselves to ensure that we still kept the records of the school. So I am wondering if the
competitive spirit that was evident in our time because of the reduced resources by way of facilities and teachers, whether it was there in your time. Because in our time, which was immediately after the war and thereafter, that was especially the driving force. But I remember hearing that Chinua Achebe, of blessed memory, despite having made the best result in his set, felt bad that a certain essay or so, who eventually read medicine, beat him in literature. So he didn't mind being beaten in any other subject but literature. And in our time, if somebody beat you in one subject or two subjects, the next exam you would struggle and struggle to ensure you beat him back. Was that, did that spirit pervade your circumstances in your time also?
So